Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to another Final Fantasy XIV video. It's definitely been a while since the last update I've done with the channel, but we're back. I believe last we left off, we were tackling a bunch of dungeons that became available to us. More specifically, just hard versions of dungeons that we've done before while doing the main story quests. So we're gonna wrap up the rest of it, hopefully in one sitting in this video. I honestly wasn't gonna go in here as a tank, but it's like, screw it. Gotta conquer my fears somehow. So as for the amount of dungeons I have left to do, I think I still have like quite a bit left to deal with. So I'm hoping I can get through all of it in this video. And then after all the dungeons are done, I believe I'm gonna start doing the raids that are available for me as well. There's two raids that I can do, but I'll figure out which one I'll start with first. So, I'll figure all of that out as I go through these dungeons, so no pressure. Alright, so far so good. First boss is just up ahead. Alright, that sting that he applies on me is actually fucking hurting me a lot right now. Oh, I can't move! Oh crap, I can't attack, I can't do anything. Oh, no, 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 no! And Black Mage is down. To be fair, that shit hurts a lot. I've died to that attack a lot when I'm in here as a DPS. Come on, almost there. Okay. Oh, stunned again. Dang. I mean, we got the boss down, but geez, we just lost our Dragoon. Oh crap, where am I going? Yeah, so I've actually, as many times I've gone through this dungeon, I've never really tanked it, so where I need to go, I'm probably gonna get lost a lot. I've only done dungeons and raids as DPS only. Less trust that way. Let's stop right here. We'll deal with these crabs first before pulling the next set of enemies. Take care of these guys, or ladies, I should say. Oh, if you guys hear any binging noises, it's actually coming from my phone. I do apologize for that. I'm about to just move that out of the way right now. All right, boss number 2. And if you guys remember, we kind of dealt with this guy way, 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 way back in the beginning of our adventure, in our first dungeon. You guys remember Captain Madison, right? And he ended up getting killed by the last boss of Sastasha when we were in here the first time around. Well, he's back and, well, he ain't looking too good.
Hmm.
Oh, hey, get away from them, get away from them. You're running away again? What the hell? And he's gone. Great. I mean, I have no business looting these chests. There's not going to be any upgrades from any of these dungeons. We're in familiar territory now, so we're pretty much at the tail end of the dungeon. I'll be careful not to pull as many enemies. Next group. Oh, I fucked up. Nice, and oh god, there's more. Oh, too many. Come on, stand still. Whew. All right. All right, Captain Madison. I'm sorry, release the what now? Oh. And get wrecked. Oh, goody. The Kraken. Is everyone ready? All right, let's do this. Ooh, get out the way, get out the way, get out the way. Pretty sure we need to go for the tentacles first, or I guess DPS can handle that. Yes, I think the game plan here is that DPS should focus on the tentacles, I focus on the actual boss itself. Oh god. I've been inflicted with blind. I can't see. Oh, I'm good. Never mind. Oop, arms are back. All right, that's good. Someone go over there and take care of that last set of arms. There you go. Oh damn, they popped up again. Almost there. Someone use a limit break. There you go. just a recap, limit break for a tank isn't really going to do damage to a boss. It's just going to give the tank and their party members a massive increase in defense for a few seconds. Limit breaks are usually reserved for DPS to finish off a boss, or in very, very rare instances or special occasions would a tank's limit break be needed. But all right, this dungeon is done. We're gonna move on to the next one. All right, we are in the next dungeon. We are in the Wanderer's Palace. We cleared this before while doing our MSQ, but we're doing the hard mode for this dungeon. So layout is gonna be different. Enemies are gonna be different. Bosses are gonna be different. Never tanked this dungeon, so we'll see how this goes. Oh god, I'm asleep. Wake me up, wake me up, wake me up! And I forgot to put my tank stance on. Holy crap, that's why we're having a hard time. All right, tank stance is on, so I think we should be doing a hell of a lot better now with these pulls. Stunned! All right, we're good. First boss of this dungeon. Ooh, so mechanic I believe is to destroy these spears whenever he throws them on the ground, because they will do party-wide damage every few seconds. Other than that, this boss is pretty easy from the looks of things. First boss done. All right. For these groups of enemies that's standing in this totem, you want to pull them out of it so you can actually defeat them or remove the buff that they have. So I got their attention. Oh, shit. Okay, this is a bad idea. Well, fuck it. We're going all in. Oh my god. I can already tell this is a bad idea. But hey, if we survive, that'll be great. We survived! Yay! That's right, follow me, follow me, follow the leader, follow the leader. Okay, risky as fuck, but let's do this. I'm gonna grab you guys as well. We're gonna stop right about here. Wow, nice. We should be up to the second boss right now. All right, this boss, crap. The mechanics for this boss. Well, I'm gonna see what he does and then just figure it out from there. I think this guy's deal is that he's gonna drop some stuff. Yeah, there he goes. He's gonna drop random totems on the ground. Some of them can actually be used by us. That'll give us a nice damage boost, I think. So that's gonna be more useful towards the DPS and maybe even the healers of the group. Just tank him down. Tank and spank, as I like to call it. The mechanics aren't exactly mind-breaking that require a lot of thoughts. You can just really burn the boss down and, you know, we'll be okay. I don't think I can say the same for the last boss for this dungeon, since there's actually a lot going on. I'm literally just going off of memory I have of running this dungeon when I'm running it as DPS. So. All right, boss number two. Here we go, this way. Thank you. Nice. Grab the key and let these tonberries go. There we go. You know, if you decided to become a healer and you became a scholar, you have a very interesting quest line with these guys. Very interesting, actually. I like it a lot. Well, not so much the quest line, rather. More like lore, story stuff involving the Tonberries and where they came from. All very interesting stuff. I believe it's the Scholar's Job quest line where it really delves into how the Tonberries came to be and what they are. Oh, wait. Gotta drain this. All right, boss time. Have to ask the group to see if they remember. Oh, there we go. So keep boss to edge of arena and move out of totems when they spawn. All right, so let's try our best to do that. So edge of the... All right, so I'm gonna go with side then. Oh crap, I just lost my archer. Damn. Alright, gotta move him again. You can see why my party member suggests just keep the boss at the edge of the arena. It makes for keeping him out of the totems a lot easier. Had I just tanked him in the middle of the arena, his totems would have been like scattered everywhere and it would have been just a really, really bad time. So it makes it easier for me to just kite him out of the totems. So thank you for that suggestion. So that's, oh God. Oh, Jesus. Well. GG. On to the next one. All right. Dungeon number, what is this? Number 3, I think. We're heading back to the Stone Vigil, but again, hard mode. We did this before during our little journey through the story quests, but we're coming back in here again to, you know, help the Ishgardians clear out more of the Dravanians, aka dragons, that are in here, or whatever else they might need help with. So let's get to it. Although I will say, from a DPS perspective, this dungeon was kind of hard. At least one of the bosses was kind of difficult to deal with. So we'll see how it is when a tank is, you know, doing this. Holy shit! Okay, bad. Very bad. About to freaking die. Okay, I'm at full health. Never mind. As far as gear goes, I will say this, I'm not exactly equipped with the best gear for level 50 right now. That is actually a work in progress and probably something I can handle in this video or just do it off screen, most likely. The gear I have on now is gear that you get after completing your level 50 job quest. But there is armor and weapons that's stronger than what you have on currently. It just takes a lot of grinding dungeons to farm the currency that's needed to buy the stronger armor set as well as the weapon. Well, scratch that. The weapon is a different story, actually. I'll explain why after this dungeon. I can try expanding it now. So essentially, for A Realm Reborn, you have something called Relic Weapons. Your Relic Weapons are available to obtain on a Warrior, Monk, Paladin, Rogue, not Rogue, sorry, Ninja, White Mage, Black Mage, I think that's it. The only issue with getting those Relic Weapons is the fact that it takes forever to get them at their absolute strongest. So if I do decide to go the route of getting my relic weapon for my warrior, I might just stop halfway, only because the later steps take way, way, way too long. So yeah. And I forgot what to do for this boss. Shit. So it looks like, holy shit, that's a big range of attack. God damn. Alright, So they're saying that there isn't really much to know about this boss fight. I'll take their word on it. Oh god, I'm getting my ass kicked right now. The only thing of note is when he runs to the other side of the room and... never mind. I was gonna say, if he goes to the other side of the room, you need to go ahead and follow him to avoid the next attack that he launches, which pretty much clears out the whole opposite end of the area. But don't gotta worry about that anymore. Oh, look. Heretics. People that worship dragons. I believe the last time we dealt with them was when we were looking for Sid's airship. Man, that was a while ago. Oh fuck! Get back here, get back here! Thank you. Oh damn, he turned into a dragon. That's not good. This way. So far, so good. Let me go ahead and pass on all of these because I'm not going to be needing any one of them. Oh, some of these cannons take down that dragon over yonder, please. Thank you. Okay, I think we're good. And oh wait, and? Oh, we still gotta deal with this thing. All right, onward. All right, next boss. I think this is the one that's a bit tricky. Give me a minute. I just want to make sure I get this right. So I am asking questions. Wait, can't damage boss style. Oh, so you have to use the cannon. Okay. All right, let's give it a shot. His defense up. Do not shoot. All right, I think we're good now. Oh, get out, get out, get out. The boss. Got it. Heads on the other hand I can deal with. Let's go. Oh, we almost got him. There we go. Yep, definitely gotta go this way. And got the key, we got the key. Oh, that's a big boy. Ah, all right. So I've just been informed that this particular boss just locks on to aggro on whoever he decides to aggro. So it doesn't matter if I have my tank stance on or not, he's just gonna go after anyone and everyone. Tank or not. So, this is gonna be great. But I guess other than that, there shouldn't be too much to worry about. Oh god! Okay, except for the maybe worry about that. Oh god, there's two of them! Well, try and keep their attention for as long as you can before they decide to go after someone else. Oh, Jesus! Almost got him. Nice. Good job. Oh. Time to move on to the next one. Party did a very good job. GG. GG's all around. Alright, next. Alright. Next dungeon. So this is legitimately my first time taking this dungeon. Well, technically that's like that with all the others, though. Tank stance on. I mean, when I say first time for this dungeon, what I mean is when I first played through the game, I never really went through this dungeon. So I don't know what the layout is, and I'm not too familiar with its layout. So I don't think I'll be doing big pulls like I've been doing in the past several dungeons. Let's give it a go. Thank you. dead end, and oh god, no. Zombies! Well, maybe not zombies, not the correct. No, yeah, they're zombies, never mind. This way again. First boss, stun him when he does a big AoE. I do have. Alright, got it. Pretty sure I messed that up. Well, they might get this if they just focus on the boss for a little bit. Come on, there you go. That will be the only time we die. So far, so good. Hold up. It's a dead end? Wait, what? Did I go the wrong way? Ah, here we go. Let's go. What the hell was that? Oh, second boss. All right. Won't kill any ads? Alright, so just focus on the boss. So don't kill the ads, and especially do not hit the eggs. Alright. Although I'm starting to think that we should probably kill the ads though, because there's a lot happening. Healer almost died. Okay, well, that worked out. Fantastic. Let's move on. Oh, this is a bad idea. Bad idea. Another boss so soon? What the heck? Alright, so I guess this is one of the, punch. Don't think, just punch. Got it. But I guess this is probably one of the only dungeons where there's three bosses in here. Well, three, mini bosses. And then the main boss. What the? They could have made this a regular enemy. It feels silly to have a. Okay, whatever. It's fine. I'm not gonna question it. Wait a minute, didn't I deal with you briefly during the MSQ? A really, really long while ago? I get to actually kill you this time, yay! So this one just avoids the boss's area of effect attacks. Got it. Oh shit. We did it! That wasn't too bad. Good stuff. Moving on. All right, I do believe this is the last dungeon that's on our list, Hullbreaker Isle. And oh my, we're missing a party member. Oh, wait, hold on. Ah, we're missing a person. I guess they might have left at the last minute or probably disconnected. I'd rather wait until... Oh, well, good news. We don't have to wait long at all because our missing DPS is here. All right. I'm gonna attempt to do a big pull. Fuck! I was nowhere near the bear trap! Come on! All right, we're gonna stop right here.
Thank you.
Oh, wait. Tree, 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 tree. Too bad. Alright, so I believe we're about to approach the second boss of the dungeon right now. Let's just put these stone tablets in. And there we go. This boss I remember. I believe when he burrows underground and there's, I believe, water or whirlpool forming in the middle of the arena or area, whatever you want to call it, you want to hop inside of these giant bubbles that spawn. That'll protect you from the area-wide attack that he does. And that's really the only thing you gotta keep an eye out for. So we don't go in there now, not yet, not yet. But you see two of these bubbles already started popping up. There you go. So it should be about now that we should go in. There we go. Go in. And we're safe. Unfortunately, our Dragoon buddy did not get the memo. So that's unfortunate. But hey, he's still alive, so. There we go. Easy. Ooh, that's a long way down, but thankfully there is no fall damage when you are in a dungeon. Grab all of you. Fuck it. Alright, last boss of this dungeon. What do we got? The Kraken? Well, if we did the dungeons in order, it would have been this dungeon first, followed by Sastasha, where we can actually deal damage to the Kraken. For this dungeon, you're just able to do damage to its tentacles only, and that's it. As for how the fight goes, kill off the tentacles. If you get a weird mark over your head, you want to move over to the next platform. Staying on the same platform as your other party members with that mark over your head will spawn a tornado, and it's going to damage you and everyone else in that area. So, best to stay clear from your teammates when that pops up. Oh, like so! Oh no! I didn't know they were still here. Scratch that. That's that weird looking tentacle is the one you want to target. And it's gone now. And I'm stunned. That's the one, and it grabbed me. It grabbed me. I'm fucked. Alright. Oh, I'm gonna stay here. Fuck that. There we go. That's the tentacle you want to aim for throughout this fight. Healer, move to another platform, quick! Aw, it ran away. Alright, where is it? Oh, I can't target it. Damn. Alright, where are you? There we go. Good job. So, with that, we've cleared off all the dungeons on my list that is currently available to us at our current level. So I'm gonna see you guys outside and we'll go ahead and chat for a bit. So, see you soon. Alrighty, so I think that pretty much wraps up today's video. We completed all of the dungeons that we managed to unlock for our level. So really the only things left on our list of things to do would be to do a few raids. One is an 8-man raid, the other is a 24-man raid. So those are going to be very interesting to do. But then there's also the matter of dealing with the primals again. I know we dealt with them before during the main story quests, but there is a side quest that involves them again. It's basically just me fighting them over again, but in hard mode. So we're gonna go ahead and probably tackle that in a little bit, probably in the next few videos or so. So the next time I see you guys, we should be wearing stronger gear, hopefully, and we'll probably go ahead and start the quest line that lets us fight the hard versions of Ifrit, Titan, and Garuda. So that's going to be fun. And I think probably a few others. I think King Moogle Mog, I think, or I forgot how it's called, but the Moogle, they're primal. We're going to be fighting him again as well, I think. I could be wrong, though, but I believe that is it for this video. Thank you all so much for tuning in, stopping by, and watching. If you did like the video, please feel free to leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more videos. And I will see you guys next time. Take care.